for all my friends and family to see this. So I'm very excited.
And
Yes.
tell me, in terms of Naomi, in terms of landing this sort of role as Alison Chambers, was it during the COVID times? Was it a taped audition? Did you have to go through one or two rounds, or were you one of those lucky enough to get to do an in-room audition towards the end, or were you sort of cast by your sort of video tryouts?
It was definitely a self-tape audition. I was working on another project at the moment, or at the time. I got this audition and I only got the first half of the script, and it was so intriguing. I was like, I have to know what happens. Send in my audition, and it was really just the one tape. I think I was waiting, like, oh, I hope I get a call back. Oh, I hope I hear something. And then they were just like, we want you. You booked it. And that was very surprising and exciting to me.
And Naomi, was you're talking there, so very much a quick turnaround. Were you waiting less than 2 weeks to hear the call?
Yes, it was a very quick turnaround. I want to say it was maybe less than 1 week. I don't want to lie, but it was very quick, like start packing your bags.
Okay, and you mentioned start packing your bags. In terms of packing your bags, where did you sort of pack your bags to go? In terms of production, in terms of location. In terms of where it was shot.
Sure, we shot in Connecticut. A lot of it was in New Milford, Connecticut. We were in Danbury for a little bit also, and we were there for, I want to say, about 3 weeks. And
Okay.
that was my first time shooting like on location too, like going packing up and going to do it instead of being here in LA. And so it's fun.
Okay. I imagine you got a flight. I imagine it's too long of a car drive to go from LA to Connecticut. I'd say you'd be the full week on the road, I imagine.
Exactly. I took a flight. I missed my first flight actually out of the Burbank airport. So then I took a Uber to the Los Angeles airport, which is a crazy airport, and I waited there for about 8 hours for my next flight. I went to a lounge because I was like, I'm not missing this one, and then I made it.
And Naomi, can you tell us a bit about your character, Alison Chambers, in terms of her role in terms of the movie? Obviously, I assume she is target number one for the crazed madman on the sort of loose. So, is it a battle of wits? Is it a battle of suspense? Is it a battle of survival? And is it a game of cat and mouse? Are you very much playing the role not only of the mouse but playing the role of the cat as well? Are you trying to suss out who and who it might be?
Sure, it's definitely cat and mouse because, of course, I'm not going to say any spoilers, but the killer kind of leaves clues at the crime scenes, and it's all of my friends who are dropping like flies. So it's definitely something that I'm trying to figure out, like Nancy Drew.
Yeah. And Naomi, in terms of wardrobe and costume, I spoke to Emily and she said it was quite intriguing. She said she took snapshots and selfies in terms of the what the wardrobe was able to do in terms of the gore and the sort of blood involved and looking like that in terms of she said she got some very good Halloween pictures out of it. Was it sort of a similar sort of experience for you in terms of wardrobe, in terms of makeup? Were there some scenes where you had to say get that sort of sinister looking look?
Yes, definitely to answer that, a lot of sinister. There was a lot of blood and it's all very cold. so that it gets messy and it kind of gets everywhere, but it's also fun because you're like, I'm allowed to make this mess. I'm also supposed to make this mess and I'm not going to get in trouble. So that was fun. And what was that?
It almost feels like you were a child in art class when you're giving paints and the brush, and the
Exactly.
teacher says,
Paint.
don't mix the colors and don't take them out, and you're just
And we're
going
like,
to,
no.
yeah.
Keep going, keep going. They're encouraging it, so it's very fun. And then in terms of wardrobe, I think that's like my favorite part always of or one of my favorite parts of the process is just like trying on clothes, and it helps you become the character. So it was very fun, and I got to keep some stuff afterwards.
Okay. And Naomi, in terms of stunts, were you sort of heavily involved? Did you sort of put on your A game, battle up the elbows and the knee pads and say, let me in, coach, I'm ready for war. I want to drive through it. Let me go if I get the knocks. I'll jump. I'll get back straight up. Was that very much the sort of attitude for you, or were you sort of a bit tentative in terms of maybe letting a stunt double do some of those sort of moving scenes?
Well, I was very excited for the stunts, and I've had a stunt double before, but on this project, none of us had stunt doubles. So we had an amazing stunt coordinator and an awesome stunt team to show us how to do things safely. And like you were saying, with pads and on your knees and elbows and on the ground, but everything that you see is actually us doing it. So I feel very proud about that. And there was definitely some times that they're like, are you okay? Like, that looked very hard, but it was still fun.
I imagine with the aches and the bruises, and especially those nighttime shooting, nighttime scenes where the chase, where you're probably arriving on set at probably around 11:30 at night, maybe 12, and you're shooting till maybe 3, 4 in the morning just to get that sort of quietness, that pitch dark effect. Did you often come back to where your lodgings or where you were staying, and you couldn't even make it to the bed? You sort of crashed on the floor or crashed on the couch due to sheer exhaustion. How did you sort of find the nighttime shooting, or did you sort of get your time, your naps during the day when you were on
I
the
think
night?
I'm always, I love a good nap, but I think that I was good about my schedule because I always like went to bed very early. Like when I'm working, I'm good with the schedule, and we didn't have too many night shoots. There was one night shoot. Our very last night was definitely probably the longest night shoot that we had. And then as soon as Eric, our director, yelled cut, it started snowing, and it was like, it was such a, and then we kind of didn't want to go home. Because it was bittersweet and we were done and we got the perfect last shot. But that was like my favorite night shoot when it started snowing.
And I suppose we have a young cast, but we have some well-established actors as well. It's important to note William Russ and Amy Hargreaves as well. Were they an old, I wouldn't say father, mother, because there's not that much years between ye, but was there sort of an older brother, older sort of sister sort of vibe going on in terms of the unity between the cast?
Very much so. And also, I was just amazed to watch people work and how they work. And someone who's like Catherine Curtin and William Russ, who are so maybe established in this industry. And this was the first movie that I've ever shot. So I was just taking notes the whole time.
Okay. And in terms of slashers, horror movies, in terms of the whole sci-fi, are you sort of drawn to that in terms of that sort of background, in terms of watching sort of sci-fi? Does it intrigue you? Emily was saying that it's not something that she would have pondered up in her TV sort of screen, but are you sort of drawn to that sort of slasher horror type? Are you are you more sensitive in terms of what you watch? Could you watch The Exorcism of Emily Rose, for example?
Okay, me and Amelia are probably gonna get in trouble if we keep saying this, but like, I wasn't a big horror girly before this, but after this, I definitely am now. Like, I'm in the theaters with my popcorn, with supporting the horror community, because it's very fun. And of course, I kind of like try to describe it to people, like people who like to go to theme parks and go on roller coasters. So we're like, why do you like that feeling in your stomach? Like, it's just exhilarating. So then I think I was like, why would I want to be scared or whatever? But then like, you get scared, but then you can laugh it off and you're in the theater with people. So I love horror movies now. To answer your question.
Okay. And Naomi, before we came on air, you mentioned you've been to Scotland, and you mentioned you came so close in terms of coming to the Emerald Isle in Ireland. Is that obviously when you get a break after a long successful year of shooting in 2024 and multiple projects? Is that on the bucket list in terms of destinations for a bit of R&R?
Definitely on my list. I've been to London, not Scotland, so I haven't even been that close. And that was my first time out of the country. So second time will be Ireland.
Perfect. And Naomi Grace, for the final 30 seconds, we might turn it over to you now. You might enlighten all our audience why they should come out en masse to the cinemas, roll up in their recliners, their seats with their popcorn, their Pepsis, their Fantas, their Maltesers, put the feet up, and watch, dare I say, Founders Day, and what's in store for them, Naomi?
I think that when you go to the theater, you will be scared, but you will have a lot of fun. It's a horror movie. There's blood and there's some guts, but there's also a lot of comedy. There's also heart to the movie, and I think you will leave feeling very satisfied.
Okay. On that note, all that's left to say is from me, Jim Conlan, to you, Naomi Grace. We wish you all the best with Founders Day out on January the 19th. But for the moment, stay safe, take care, Naomi, and God bless.
Thank you. You too.